I just want to share with you my thoughts on the media narrative, how the media kind of manipulates messages and wants us to buy and believe what they say. Now, for example, this latest incident that took place, 8 people died in USA, people from Atlanta. And they were, majority of them, 6 of them were Asian Americans. Okay. Now, this is not to devalue or disrespect their death. I have nothing to say about the people who died. It's unfortunate. Irrespective of what nationality, irrespective of what religion, what background, it's wrong. Okay. But now I want you to focus your thoughts on this killer. Who was the killer? American citizen, white guy. But did you notice that the media has not branded him as Christian extremist, Christian terrorist, or white supremacist, or whatever? They just put man, he kills. You see the headlines, you see the narrative. Okay, had it been a Muslim guy, they would have said Islamic terrorist. They would have said, you know, ISIS and this and that. Now, let's be fair. They would have said Islamic terrorist if he had shouted Allah Akbar, and they have this stupid habit. Allah Akbar and they explode. Allah Akbar and they shoot. Allah Akbar and I don't know what is Allah Akbar about killing someone. Such people are seriously, it's a disease. Okay. Now, had this guy said Jesus Christ this and Jesus Christ that, then yes, they would have said Christian terrorist. But now, see, I'm being fair to both the sides. Okay. Now, they would have said Muslim terrorist if he had said Allah Akbar. But I'm pretty sure even if he didn't say Allah Akbar and he was a Muslim, they would have said Arab Muslim, Islamic extremist and all that. Fine. But now comes a deeper issue, that is, in Christianity, do they teach about killing and jihad? And in Islam, do they teach about this? See, now I've given you a complete circle of all the facts, both the sides. I've not supported one side and I'm not speaking against the other side. I'm being fair. But my main focus here was, you see how they address the headlines for this? They don't say Muslim terrorist. No, they didn't say Christian terrorist. You know, they didn't say Christian fundamentalist. They didn't even focus on the white, guy. Just a man kills. Do you think they would have done the same thing for a Arab Muslim or guy who is a Muslim follower? So, this is one part of the narrative. Now, why am I bringing this up? The reason I'm bringing this up is not to create divide. It's not to create Hindus versus Christians versus Muslims versus Hindus, no. The way the media brainwashes you. Now, for example, think about Obama. When Obama stood for elections, what did he promise? Change. Yes, we can. He said, yes, we can and change. Sounded very nice, right? Even I fell for it when I heard about it. It's like, fuck, change is going to come. Yes, we can. What happened? What was the change? You remember anything? Any change took place? In fact, more people were killed during Obama's time. More people were killed in terms of war. More wars were fought. More weapons were sold. In fact, for those people who are crucifying Donald Trump, that he jailed these children away from the parents. Have you ever done your research? How many people Obama deported? How many people Obama put in jail? Guantanamo Bay. How many people he imprisoned unlawfully? In fact, what happened about Edward Snowden? What about Julian Assange? He calls them traitors for telling the truth. So please explain to me. Tell me, if I'm wrong or right, you tell me, no? Edward Snowden, reveal to the world the truth. Obama said, why don't you come down to USA and we'll give justice. You seriously think if Edwin Snowden surrenders himself to US authorities, they'll give justice? In fact, did Obama admit that they had breached the privacy laws, that everyone was being spied upon? Did he admit? No. But see how beautifully he said, change, yes we can. And they portrayed Donald Trump as a bad guy. Now, they're saying Joe Biden stands for unity. Stands for, yes, together we'll do it and all that, blah, blah. They're not speaking about what is he doing other side. They just focus on the publicity bit. See, Joe Biden is continuing Trump's policies of jailing the children, separating them. Why is nobody talking about it? Don't believe me, just do your research. No, just search. See, because the logic is similar. You remember this female, Alexandria Cortez, AOC. She, like an idiot, she was asking this guy, who was the head of, I think, the police task force or something. She was asking him, I need to know, why have you separated children from their parents while arresting people? Why have you separated them? This guy is slightly an old guy. He responds, Congresswoman, when you arrest someone, you arrest them for breaking the law. And when you're arresting someone, it's not a family get together, you know? It's not like, oh, father, mother, all together. He said, if tomorrow I break the law and I'm arrested, I will be separated from my wife and kids. Just imagine, when you get jailed, does your wife and babies, they come with you to jail? No. When you get arrested, you're handcuffed and you're taken in. So of course you're separated. So he said, when you break the law, first is you're breaking the law. Why are you breaking the law? That's number one. Second one is, after you break the law, you get arrested. So when you get arrested, you can't come with your children and wife. She couldn't answer that. And she couldn't answer why they're breaking the law. See, they don't mention all this. They just say, oh, separating children. Why the fuck are you breaking the law with your children? Then you'll say, yeah, they're escaping eternity. Fine. Then let them apply the proper way. Who's applying the proper way? You support illegal immigrants, then you give them the housing, no? See, Alexandria Cortez, how many people has she given housing? How many people has she looked after? Even Obama. You seriously think Obama or Biden or even Donald Trump, you think they care about you? You think they love you? They have your best interest in mind? You're a stupid fool to think, oh, if they come to office, I will be taken care of. Oh, they will love me so much. Oh, my job will be secure. Oh, so nice. No, you're a fucking idiot, man. If you think your problems are going to be solved by electing someone, you're fucking stupid. They will just give you some nice bullshit and they will use the media to give you nice messages and you fall for it. What do advertisers do? Fair and Lovely. There's one Indian cream. It's called Fair and Lovely. People buy this cream. Had this cream been in USA, they would get sued for misrepresentation. It doesn't make you fair, it doesn't make you lovely. Fair and handsome. They have been advertising Nutella as a healthy breakfast, Kellogg's as a healthy breakfast. Please tell me, eating processed food with sugar in it, is it healthy? But they advertise. See the pyramid of eating food. What is at the lowest? What is at the highest? Is it healthy? See, the problem is the media gives you fucking information and you just buy it, you eat it without questioning. Nowadays, you get these internet marketers. Oh, earn 7-figure income in 7 days. Get 6-pack abs with 6-minute exercise. People buy it because they want bullshit. That's why the media plays you. Now, when they give you all these, oh, racist tweet, oh, climate change, oh, this or that, oh, people just buy it. And without using their brains, oh, Elon Musk says, oh, Bitcoin will go up. Everyone ran and buying it. Oh, he sexually tried to molest her. She cried. Oh, the poor girl. Oh, the guy is a bastard. The problem with the media narrative is, whatever people say, people buy into it. That is why WhatsApp and Facebook and social media. Hey, look at this. You see this? Lizard. Hi, lizard. How are you? Bye. See you. Bye. That was a nice one. You know, if it was a snake, I wouldn't be so close. So what I was saying was, you know, in India, they had this situation where people were just sharing a so-called forward, like a sharing a forward that people driving this car, they were kidnapping children and they were selling them. And they said it is a four-wheel drive and all that. And then these villagers started forwarding to everyone. Before you know it, the whole village had this message forwarded to them. And they were busy hunting a four-wheel drive with men in it. Unfortunately, they found two guys who were just on a holiday trip, youngsters from college. The villagers rounded them up and they killed them. You can Google search this incident. Because fake news was shared. Today, so many people share WhatsApp forwards. They share images which have been photoshopped. They share news which outlets claim. Like for example, Indians would know this guy. His name is Arnab Goswami. He calls himself a journalist. He calls himself a media person. All he does is, he's a potty mouth. He just shouts and screams. He's a very intelligent guy. He's a smart businessman. But he represents one political party for his own benefit. See, end of the day, all politicians, all, left or right or center or, there is no saint, man. When will you understand this? Elon Musk, you think, cares about you when he says Bitcoin will go up, Tesla stocks are up, or Dogecoin, buy it. You think he really cares about you? You think Narendra Modi, Donald Trump, Joe Biden, they really love you, they want your best interest in mind, they want you to succeed, they want your family to be taken care of. When they say Obama care, care for all, this and that, you don't think that there is something going on, there's some hidden agenda. When they're saying we need to fight the evil Iranian regime, the evil communist, and they're not selling weapons and making money and they get kickbacks, you don't think they have all this agenda? You think only the Chinese are bad and only Iranians are bad and only Americans are good, rest everyone is bad? Oh, 5G, China is so evil. USA, you think, is a saint. They're not going to use 5G for their benefit. You think European countries don't spy on others? Come on, man. When the fuck will you grow up? Even after all the information is provided, even though you have people like Edward Snowden and Julian Assange, still people don't use your fucking brain. Still, they are brainless idiots. That's why you have idiots on this planet. Hero worship. See, keep in mind, the bottom line is simply this. Nobody is your well-wisher. Nobody does anything for free. Nobody is your friend. Everyone has their own agenda. And the bigger a guy is, the more powerful a guy is, the more successful a guy is, even more manipulative he is. And Obama, Biden, Donald Trump, all are the same. All are the same. Each one has their own agenda in mind. And each one gets benefits from certain people. It's only the lesser of two evils. So the question is, which evil do you support? Anyway, I just hope you can think about this and use your common sense. I don't know. Provided you have common sense. If you do, use your brains and think. If you don't, be a sheep and let the world guide you. Tell you to go this way, you go this way, go that way, go that way. And one fine day you'll grow old and die. You'll wonder what the fuck happened in life. While these guys at the top, they will achieve the agenda. And like Obama, change. Yes, we can. Sweet talker. Amazing. And end of the day, like George Bush, yes, we destroyed the weapons of mass destruction. All the political parties, all the government officials said, yes, we have evidence for weapons of mass destruction. From Colin Powell to Condoleezza Rice to Tony Blair. weapons of mass destruction. What happened in the end? Any accountability? They killed so many people, they killed Saddam Hussein, they did all this plundering, oil, this, that. Anybody was held accountable? Nothing. Life went on. People who had to suffer and who had to die, died. And life goes on. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share. Let me know your thoughts. It's me signing off. You guys take care.